Good morning. You're listening to FloridaDaily.net, and I'm Kim Parr. This morning, my guest is Peter Green, who's Vice President of Marketing with Interface. Peter, how you doing?
Doing really well. Good morning, Kim.
Good morning. Thanks for being with me. I know you're in LaGrange now. Just to speak a moment about that, I saw you at Greenbuild in San Francisco, and then you last week you were in New York at the Interior Design Best of Year Awards. Now you're in LaGrange. You're probably going through a little cultural shock, aren't you?
This is my life.
Yeah, well, I know you've been in the interiors business for a while, first in furniture and now in flooring, and wanted to talk to you about last week's events. Just for our listeners' benefit, talk a little bit about what happened last week in New York around the Interior Design Best of Year Awards.
I'd be happy to, Kemp. As many people know, the Interior Design Awards began about 30 years ago, I think 28 years ago precisely. And then that's an annual event where noteworthy designers are inducted into a Hall of Fame. It's a big gala event at the Waldorf Astoria. It's a black tie affair. 1,300 people attend. And it's kind of like the Oscars for the interior design business. Around about 10 years ago, Interior Design Magazine, which is the host of the awards, thought, wouldn't it be appropriate to honor projects and products? So they started a second day event, which takes place the day right after the evening of the Hall of Fame Awards. Mm-hmm. And it's a growing competition where product manufacturers enter their products and designers who have not been inducted have the ability to enter their projects for consideration. There's altogether, I think, over 500 projects and products that get entered. They then go through a online voting process this year. Cindy Allen informed us that 21,000 people voted online. Mm-hmm. And then the winner is selected out of a list of four or five finalists that are selected by the online voting. Mm-hmm. So it's a relatively recent event, and we're delighted that we won not one but two Best of Year product awards last week, one in the modular carpet category for Walk the Planks and a second in the green flooring category for Urban Retreat.
Now, what is your history? You've won several of these awards, haven't you?
Yeah, we won last year for Raw, which was kind of a breakaway product for us, similar to Walk the Plank product.
Mm-hmm. All right, so let's back up just a minute. The big black tie event, that's the first night. It's mostly cocktails and dinner. And then how long does the awards ceremony take?
That ends around 11 o'clock, starts at 6:30. The second evening is a little bit shorter, and that's actually a lot more fun.
Yeah.
It's held in a different venue, it's much less structured, a little bit more wine flowing, and a little bit more relaxed atmosphere.
Yeah, and actually that second day had to move because of Hurricane Sandy, didn't it?
Yeah, they were originally going to host it in the IAC building, which is one of the creative arts management companies that have I believe it's a Frank Gehry building on West Street, but their basement and ground floor had been flooded, so they moved it into the Goldman Sachs auditorium and adjacent space, and to no surprise, Goldman Sachs, which sits right on the river, had gotten through the storm without a problem. In fact, they had their own power, their own pumps, and they operated 24/7, and they were very generous in hosting the event for interior design.
And appropriate for that event, that's a newly built building and quite architectural, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah. Okay.
Stunning space.
All right, so let's talk, not to sound like Joan Rivers, but I'm sure, you know, the first night's a black tie event, the second night's casual. The reason I know it's casual, I've seen some pictures that are on the web, and I've seen your picture, I guess because you won an award and you were wearing blue jeans and an open collar. Do you get to a sense of a lot of fashion and design? I know designers don't just work with buildings. They also, the way they dress and their appearance is always quite catchy. Was that fun to watch?
I would say on both days there were some really noteworthy outfits. The difference being that the first night is a formal event, so everybody is really dressed, whether they're in conventional or idiosyncratic clothes, it's a high style.
Yeah.
The second night is a more casual. It's just a fun event, and what's especially exciting is the opportunity to view all these design projects that have been submitted, and there's an average of 5 to 6 images for each project, and Cindy Allen just bangs through them in a projector in about like 1 per second. So it's kind of like watching design spaces on crack.
Well, I've got, you know, since this is your business, you're talking about candy for the senses. I'm sure they have great projection, high definition visuals. Did you say there were several hundred entries, right?
Oh, yes. I think there were over 400 entries altogether.
Yeah. And they plow all through those and it doesn't get monotonous.
No, I think she keeps it moving.
And you won with two products. This modular product, is that one you introduced this year?
Yes, we introduced it in February, March of this year. It's called Walk the Planks. Mm-hmm. It's also known as a skinny tile. It's 25 by 100 centimeters. Mm-hmm. It has the look of aged, weathered hardwood planks.
Yeah.
And some of the installation benefits of hardwood, so you can form herringbone or ashlar installations, and it really takes on a beauty all of its own on the floor. It installs glue-free with our tack tiles. We think it's kind of a breakaway product, and I wouldn't be surprised if you see more from us shortly.
Good. And the environmental product that won, why did it win?
That was Urban Retreat, which was our Neocon launch this year. And Urban Retreat is based on the application of some biophilic design principles. So we tried to bring some color, texture that might be familiar from you in nature, bring that into the indoors and into the carpeting. There's a very interesting aspect of the Urban Retreat 1 series where it literally looks like moss has grown into cracks or crevices in a rock formation and spreads from there. So very beautiful product, very restful and inspiring, and has all the benefits of the high recycled content that come with our Glassback RE backing and the 100% recycled face fiber.
Well, that fits real nicely with your green build message, your biophilia message, doesn't it?
Yeah, in fact, we introduced a skinny plank version of that Urban Retreat product at Greenbuild last month.
All right. Well, Peter, thanks for taking time out of your morning. Again, we've been talking to Peter Green about the Interior Design Best of Year Awards last week in New York, and you've been listening to Kempar and FloorDaily.net.